Hello guys, welcome to my channel Fundamentals of Engineering. In today's session we are going to see introduction and construction details of lathe machine. So if we know that lathe machine is the father of all the machines, so what is the use of lathe machine and what are the different parts or construction details of this lathe machine that we are going to see. Before starting to this session, I request everyone to subscribe my channel, click on bell icon to get more notifications. If you want to cover any topics related to engineering background, please put that topic name in comment box. So now we are going to start our actual session. So first we will see the evaluation of lathe machine. So in this picture you will see how the evaluation is started from the Egypt in the ancient 300 BC to ancient India, how the lathe machines is evaluated. Now the lathe machine is the oldest machine tools. This device is compound to develop through centuries, and in the year 1797 Henry Maudslay, an Englishman, designed the first screw lathe, cutting lathe, which is forerunner of the present day high speed heavy duty production lathe. So this is the evaluation of lathe machine, how the lathe machine is evolved from the scratch to the now automatic machines that we have seen in every industry, small scale and medium scale, they are using this lathe machine. Now if you see today's era, in this the lathe machines are changed by the CNC machine, but the principle and construction details of lathe machine is advanced in terms of CNC machine, that is computer numerical control machines. As we know that whenever we want to get the final product from the workpiece, which is a raw material, the three important parameters are man, material and machine. So from the material we have to remove the part and we have to get the final shape. For that we require the man who is performing the operation, and these operations are carried out on a particular machine. So for this, in today's session we are going to see the lathe machine. What is the main function of lathe? It is remove the material from the workpiece and will get the required shape and size. So whatever the removal of the workpiece is in terms of chips. So this image is taken from the internet. You can see the work, the final shape of the work we are getting from the raw material with the application of this cutting tool. So once the cutting tool is performing operation, the spindle speed is given to this workpiece, then we'll get the final shape with the required quality and dimensional accuracy, and this we are getting based on the removal of the chip. So the main function of lathe is to get the required shape and size of the workpiece with the removal of chips from the work material. So here we'll get the idea what is the main function of lathe machine. So to achieve this, the work must be held rigidly on the machine table. So this is the workpiece, we want to hold that with this chuck. So whenever we are doing the operations on the lathe machine, we have to hold the work, which is a raw material, with the help of chuck. The chuck can be different type, 3-jaw chuck, 4-jaw chuck. From that we have to hold tightly whenever we are performing the operations. So if the rotation moment is given to the workpiece against the cutting tool, which remove the work or which remove the material from the work in the form of chip. So if the rotation moment is given to the workpiece against the cutting tool, then we are getting the work or material is removed from the workpiece in the form of chip. The chip will be formed and will get the desired dimensional accuracy and shape. That previous picture it will clear that chip is formed as whenever that chip is forming, we are getting the desired surface finish and accuracy, dimensional accuracy. So on the rotating workpiece, we are applying the cutting tool which moving in the feed direction, and it will remove the material in the form of chip to get the desired shape. So to overcome that, first we are going to see what are the constructions details of the lathe machine. So what are the different parts of lathe machine that we are going to see. So to cut the material properly, if we know the function, primary function, the tool must be harder than the material of the workpiece and should be held rigidly in the machine and should be paired into definite way to relative to the work. So first we are going to see what are the parts. So first is the legs. On these legs, the bed is kept. So bed is the base of the machine. The bed material should have high compressive strength, should be wear resistance and absorb vibration. As we know, whenever we are doing the operation on the lathe machine, the vibration which are generated, that will affect the surface finish of the work. Also, it will affect the tool life of the tool. To overcome that, whatever the vibrations which we are generated, this vibration must be absorbed by this bed. So the material should be a high compressive strength, should be wear resistance, and it has to absorb vibration. So we are using cast iron alloy with nickel and chromium forms a good material suitable for lathe bed. So cast iron alloy with the nickel and chromium we are using as a bed material. Then next is a headstock. It held permanently in the inner ways of the left hand end of the lathe bed. It provides mechanical means of rotating the work at a multiple speed, that for the rotation of the workpiece, the driving mechanism is provided at the headstock. It consists of hollow spindle and mechanism of driving and alternating the spindle speed. So the mechanism of driving and alternating the spindle speed, for that it is attached to this headstock. All the parts are housed within the headstock casing. So all the parts which are there, it is attached with the headstock casing. We are using material that is nickel chromium steel. The headstock material is a nickel chromium steel. On this headstock, the chuck is kept. This chuck, there are different types, 3-jaw chuck, 4-jaw chuck. So in that chuck, we are keeping the workpiece, or we are holding the workpiece tightly. So whenever we are giving the rotation moment to this workpiece, it is given with the chuck. So the driving mechanism which is there in the headstock, that driving mechanism will give the rotation moment to the workpiece through this chuck. Next is a tailstock. It is located at the right hand end of the lathe bed. This has two main uses. It supports the other end of the work when it is being machined between center. So whenever we are doing the any turning operations, for that to hold the work to the other end, the tailstock is used. Also, it holds the tool for performing operations such as drilling, reaming, tapping. So we can insert the tool of drilling, a drill tool, at the tailstock so that it will perform the operation very effectively. So these are the main uses of this tailstock. Next one is a carriage. The carriage of lathe has several parts that serve to support, move and control the cutting tool. It consists of following parts like saddle, cross slide, or compound rest, we can call it as, or a tool post. This is a tool post. On this tool post, we are having a tool holder. This is holds the tool. This is located at the top of the compound race to hold the tool and to enable it to be adjusted to a convenient working position. The type and mounting of the tool post depends upon the class of work for which it is to be used. The rigidity of the tool holder and effective method of securing are the essential factors in the designing a tool post. Common types of tool post are single screw tool post, four bolt tool post, open side tool post, four way tool post. Based on the application, how the tool we are using, which tool we are using, based on that we can use this type of tool post. And the tool which we are using for performing operations, any operations, that tool must have higher strength than the work material. Also, whatever the hot hardness temperature of tool should be higher than the workpiece material, because whenever we are doing the machining operation, the temperature will be generated due to cutting forces or contact between workpiece and tool. Due to friction, the temperature is higher. If that temperature is going beyond the hot hardness temperature, then the tool material, whatever it is having a strain, that will be loosed down, so it will not perform the operation. Also, we have to use the highest strain tool to get a proper machining or proper removal of the metal from the workpiece. Then last one is a lead screw. Lead screw is a long threaded shaft used as a master screw, and it brought incorporation only when threads have to be cut. Whenever we want to do the threading operations, there we can use this lead screw. In all other times, the lead screw is disengaged from the gearbox and remains stationary, but this is the way used to provide motion for turning, boring, etc. in lathes that are not equipped with a feed rod. So what are the different operations, lathe operation, that we are going to see in the next session. So this is the part or construction details of a lathe machine. Now we are going to see what are the types of lathe machine. First one is a woodworking. Based on the operations, these are the types of lathe: centering, polishing, spinning, belt drive, individual motor device, gear head lathe, bench lathe, tool room lathe, capstan and turret lathe, wheel lathe, gap bed lathe, T lathe, duplicating lathe, and last one is a automatic lathe. So now if you see in our industry, small scale or medium scale industry also, we have changed whatever the previous lathe with the automatic lathe, so that we will get the good quality surface finish, also dimensional variation with a better accuracy. So these are the types of lathe. Now we are going to see some of the pictures of the lathe. So this is the actual view of the lathe. In that you can see the coolant house. So whatever the heat generated during the machining operations, so due to this heat, that will hamper the cutting capacity of a tool, that the tool may wear out or it will not do the proper machining. Also the surface finish we are getting on the workpiece, that will hamper. So to overcome that or to lower the temperature, we are using coolant, so that whatever the heat which is generated, that be lower down, not 100%, but due to up to some extent it can be lowered out. For that we are using this coolant. So this is the picture of a capstan lathe. This is a turret lathe. This is an automatic lathe. So in this automatic lathe, we can fade the programs, that is automatic program that is based on the numbers and alphabets, and based on that this machine can perform the operation by taking the different tools based on the process we require, and that will give the good results to the part or to the workpiece. So this is the automatic lathe, or we can call it as a CNC. So in this session we have seen some introduction to the lathe machine, also the construction details of a lathe machines. What are the parts are there in a lathe machine? What is its function of that part? That we have seen. If you like it, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you want to cover any topic, please put that topic name in comment box. Thank you. Thank you very much.